Alright guys, here we are on field 29. Loading me up 29 course. Yeah, we're set at what would be around 15.6. Unfold our 50-foot disc. Plow in these beans. Because they no good. Disking in MPK, PK, nitrogen, lime, pretty much everything is going into this field. Right up here next to the beet piling facilities. All the land you can see from here, we actually are farming. You have field 20, 15, 12, 11, 10. We just did 34 in the last video. A little bit of wing flex here going on. Always nice to see. I'm surprised Giants doesn't do that as like a default. They just finally added flex to the input attachers on the combines in 15 and 13. It was rigid. So if you went on kind of like an uneven terrain, your combine would get all snagged up on the ground because you have no flex in your flex draper. Field 17, I really like field 17. That was fun to harvest on. So we still have a lot of chisel plowing to do. Spent a tremendous amount of money on nutrients. We have about 90,000 in seed left to go. And then probably two more days of chisel plowing before we get to plant anything. Wish I had a little seed drill so I could go ahead and drill in that alfalfa. I'd like to get that growing when everything else is waiting around. I think this disc is one of my best ideas yet. Can you imagine driving this thing in real life? Finally get to use the GPS. Woo! Pretty dirty now. Probably a little too dusty outside to have that door open. headlamp over here. It's a little too tight. Last time I was cultivating this field was with the Kuhn Kraus 66-35. I think we're up to 1,268 acres. Actually, probably a little bit more than that because we expanded the northeast part of 25. There's a grassy patch, probably 5-10 acres, 7 acres. I don't know, so we're probably around 1,270 acres we're farming now. Dirt road's looking mighty nice. It's corn residue though. Looks so nice right now. So we were just talking about how deceivingly big this field is. Like, when you're looking at it, you're like, oh, it's not that big of a field. But then when you actually like pan out and like you're covering, it's pretty freaking big. It's like 27 hectares. So I don't know. You're looking at probably a 75-ish acre field right here. So. It's like 27 or 29 hectares, so it's a pretty significant sized field, and it took us quite a while to spread the nutrients with two DNs in the field, and even working with a 50-foot disc is going to take some time to disc it up. We're not the same working with as our 227. Our two 2720s, the working width is about 8.5, 9 meters. So, we're about, 15.5. We're about 1.5, 2 meters less than both of our 2720s combined, but we could pull this a little bit faster than we can pull the 2720, so we're actually covering more ground per hour with this than we would with two 2720s, so. I'm not quite sure if we'd be able to keep ahead of a DB60 planter, we'd have to probably be a field ahead of our planter guy. We pull that planter at 9 miles an hour and it's like 18 something, 60 feet. This is 50 foot, so. Feet less in working width, but 3 miles an hour faster. I'm not sure if we would maintain ground, lose ground, or gain a little bit, but definitely I think would need to be pretty good ways ahead of a DB 60 planter. I'd say probably at least 10 passes in just to stay ahead where it's comfortable, where you're not getting too close. So we have that huge, the large field 44 to disc 26, 27, 28. So we have, I don't know what that is, probably 250 more acres of disking to do, roughly. We're plowing these beans because we don't even have any nutrients that register in this field, so we just put down all four and then we're disking in this residue just to give it a basically head start, biggest head start we can, just to get those nutrients up to a respectable level. So what are we planting here? We're in field 29. This is going to be canola. Cool, cool. So it's 44. Seed cost. Yeah, so we're almost like 200,000 into nutrient application in our fields, so. Then we got 100 grand in seed and like 150,000 in land lease. To be totally honest, I'm getting a little sick of soybean and corn, so we're starting to go into like barley and wheat, and you know, we have our alfalfa and canola, but I was thinking of maybe adding in some sunflower and sucorn and I don't know, maybe some other kind of oil seed, just to get a little bit of diversity, a little bit more diversity here. I'd like to have like little green peas, but didn't make like a oxbow pea harvester, but I would probably go with like a peanut lifter, or like a new sugar beet pull type lifter before I'd ever do that. But I think what I have to do is I have to finish making these tip on this piler here in animation, because right now it uses the old 13 map trigger, so if I were to convert that over to the new 15 animation trigger, I could probably get away with doing sugar beats on this map on the server. Just rent a self-propelled, and then have guys in trucks and oxbow tipper. And we can store the beats, or we could just sell them at the piler.